Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to download and set up an Overwatch overlay in OBS Studio. Let's get right into it. To celebrate the release of one of our favorite games to play, we created a free-to-use overlay for Overwatch. If you like this design, let us know by commenting below. We're thinking about making this design into an animated version, which would be free as well, so subscribe to catch any updates on that. Let's head over to nerdordie.com to download all the files that you'll need. The direct link will be in the description. In our Pay What You Want store, you'll find this overlay. You can check out some previews of the images here if you'd like. To download, set the price that you'd like to pay. I'm going to put it at $0 and hit Add to Cart. Next, I'm going to click View Cart and then proceed to checkout. Your email address is required here so that you can be sent the download links. But you'll also get direct access to the links on the website after you hit Place Order. On this page, you can simply download the items you'd like to use. If you do decide to enter an amount greater than $1, there will be an extra step via PayPal to make your purchase complete, but please feel free to download this and use as you'd like. If you're not sure which items you like, of course you can just download them all, or go back to the product page and view the previews again. As I mentioned earlier, you'll receive an email that contains the download links as well. Let's move on to setting up this overlay in OBS Studio. To set up your supporters section, you can simply add in an image source and choose the layout you like by browsing your newly downloaded images. I'm going to add in panel-layout 1. Here, you can simply drag it in to resize it a bit and then position it where you like. From here, we can add in our donation labels as a text source. For the font, I'm going to select Big Noodle Tilting. I'll also set the font style to italic. I'll make sure that the link to this font is in the description below as well. Make sure you set a font size appropriate for how big you made your image, and then you'll need to link your donation labels via the Read From File option. If you're not sure how to do this part, I'll link another video in the description below that will help you out with this. We also want to right align the text for this. To do so, right-click the text source that we added and go to Transform, Edit Transform. Here, change the positional alignment to top right. The pack also includes blank supporter panels named panel-2, 3, and 4. You can add in this image in the same way and then add text sources with a dark color to make your own headings. This is just in case the templates don't fit the requirements or what you wanted to set up. You can also right-click the image and go to Transform, Flip Horizontal to mirror this image in case you wanted to use left-aligned panels. Don't forget that you can use the arrow keys for fine-tuning your positioning inside of OBS for your text sources that might need to be nudged just a little bit. Next, the HUD part of this overlay is a simple image. Just add it in as an image source. And that's that. You can position this at the top or bottom of your screen. To flip it, right-click it and go to Transform Flip Vertical. Since this is a blank HUD, you can easily add in more text sources to create a nameplate, or you could even use this as your supporters section instead of the panels that we just set up if you prefer. Get creative with how you use this and how you use the images together with text sources and create your own unique overlay. You could even add color correction filters to these images to match your brand color. There's a ton of great options with OBS Studio that you can use to make this overlay unique to your own channel. If you need more information about how to use filters, check out my other video on the subject. We cover everything that you'll need to know. Finally, we need to add in the webcam. First, let's add in our own webcam, which is a video capture device. I'm going to set my resolution FPS type to custom and select 1280 by 720 for my resolution. Next, I'm going to add a filter to my webcam so that I can create round corners so that everything sort of fits properly. Right-click the source and go to Filters. Click the plus for an effect filter and add an image mask blend. Leave this on Alpha Mask and browse to find the webcam-mask file. Select it and close out the filter section. We'll see that our webcam has been cropped a little and has rounded corners. Let's add in an image source and select the webcam template we'd like to use. I'll select the cam-twitter-youtube file and hit OK. Once it's added in, we can easily resize both our webcam and this image source and position it where we'd like it. Again, most of these templates have been left blank so that you can add in custom text sources with the information you'd like to include. There's even templates with no areas for text if that's what you prefer. Well, that's about it for the setup of this overlay design. I really hope you enjoy it, and I hope everyone out there has a great time playing Overwatch. Please let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. As I mentioned before, if you're interested in an animated version of this, where we'll add some cool glow effects and maybe even a bit more, let us know in the comments below as well, or by sending us a tweet. Make sure to subscribe to Nerd or Die for more great free resources and video game related content. Thanks for watching.